every single thing that you've gone through equips you to be able to do what you were born to do.
Welcome back to the Find Your Purpose Now podcast. Today, I want to talk about the way we feel about ourselves, the way we think of ourselves, the way we talk about ourselves. A lot of us have a negative self-perception. Some of us don't like ourselves very much, and we don't know how to change it. We don't know how to be any different or do any differently. Some of us are kind of, I won't say we're trapped, we feel like we're trapped in a personality that doesn't reflect who we really are on the inside. It's a hard thing to go through life feeling like you don't like yourself, because when you don't like yourself, or if you go so far as to say you hate yourself, then you automatically think other people hate you too, or they don't like you. And if you think that people don't like you, you automatically assume that you're not invited, that you're not wanted, that you don't belong. And all of those things are horrible feelings. And, you know, the reality is sometimes it's true. Sometimes people don't want us around. And it could be that, you know, we bring the room down because we're down. We make other people feel negative when we feel negative. It's contagious. That feeling of hating ourselves, or at least disliking ourselves. We can try to hide it, but you can't hide it for very long. You can, be in short conversations or have short bursts of interaction where you can disguise it pretty well. But after so long, it shows, it comes out. And some people figure it out right away. Some people know there's something wrong and they can't quite put their finger on it, but they don't like it. It doesn't feel good. And so when we don't like ourselves, when we hate ourselves, it gets even worse when our words and actions and behaviors repel other people. So what do you do? Well, I understand, because I didn't like myself. I spent a lot of years feeling like I was no good, like I was just trash that somebody had thrown out. And the evidence in my life supported that, because my mother left me with a neighbor when I was a little girl and she never came back. She had other kids she kept, but she never came back for me. My father moved on, married another person, and they had their life, and so he didn't come back for me. So the evidence, just that evidence, suggested that I was unwanted, unloved, trash to be thrown out. And then the people who raised me were abusive and chaotic and dysfunctional and addicted and mentally ill, a lot of things. So each of us, when we have these feelings like we don't like ourselves or hate ourselves, they come from someplace. So the first thing that you can do to help yourself is to figure out where all that originated. Was it a parent? Was it a sibling? I mean, that can be a real thing. an older sibling who thought, you know, they were the baby of the family or they were the only child. And now you came along and you ruined their whole, you ruined their whole life because now they no longer get the attention, or they think that you're the reason that they don't get the attention they would like. So, you know, maybe it was a best friend or somebody you liked who blew you off, or somebody that, you know, a group of mean kids who didn't include you, made fun of you, made you feel like an outcast. Wherever it came from, let's go back and figure it out. Because I can tell you that in my case, when I looked back as an adult and I said, okay, you know, my mother left me. Let me think about her. Of course, I don't know what was in her head or what was in her heart, but I can speculate that something was wrong. I mean, the average decent person doesn't ask a neighbor to babysit and leave their child and never come back. So something was wrong with her. That doesn't mean something was wrong with me. She made that choice. So if you go back and you can start to figure out where these feelings came from in you, look at that person. Was that person not in their right mind? Were they mentally ill? Did they use substances that impaired their thinking? Were they just jackasses? Did somebody hurt them and so made them mean and hurtful, and they turned around and they were mean and hurtful to you? That's the first thing. Figure out where it came from, because all of that belongs to them. We take ownership of that stuff because typically it happens before we're old enough to really think it through and put it into context and put it into perspective and say, oh, you know, old uncle so-and-so said that, you know, he's just not right anyway, so I'm just going to dismiss it. We don't do that as children. When people say and do things to us when we're children, we automatically take ownership of it. I must be horrible. I must be a terrible kid. I'm a bad kid. I'm a bad person. I'm a bad seed. Oh, I'm just like my father. Oh, I'm just like my mother. Whatever it is that people have said. And as children, we just believe it. So what I'm asking you to do today, I mean, sooner than later, don't put this off. Give some thought to where those negative feelings and emotions came from. Who gave you the impression that you weren't good? Who gave you the impression that you weren't wanted? Or that you were worthless? In your now a mature adult thinking, put some perspective around that. Put some context around that. The person who said it didn't know you. They didn't know who you really are. I don't care if they've known you your whole life and they were there when you were born, or if they birthed you. They don't know who you really are. So they don't get to put that on you. They may have for a lot of years, but today is the day that can change, and it's your decision to make it change. We get to choose our feelings. We choose how we want to feel. I always say, nobody can make me feel anything. unless I allow it. Now, if I dwell on it and think about it and begin to feel sorry for myself, yeah, I can go there. Mm-hmm. I know how to go there. I know that path. It was a well-worn path for a lot of years of my life. I understand now, however, that when my mother left and when my caregivers abused me, they didn't know the potential that was inside of me. They didn't know who I really was. I was young. I couldn't articulate it. The potential of what I was able to accomplish in my life was still just a seed. And I feel like they did just about everything they could to kill it. But I decided not to let that happen. I want you to make that same decision. Don't let other human beings, other flawed human beings, make that decision for you. You protect who you are. You protect your potential, but you won't do it if you don't think that you're a good person. You won't do it if you don't like yourself. You won't do it if you hate yourself. So let's talk now about what's inside of you and who you really are. Because when you begin to understand what's inside of you, I guarantee you, you won't dislike yourself anymore. You won't hate yourself anymore because you'll understand the good things, or you'll begin to, that are inside of you. The seeds that maybe haven't yet grown and manifested themselves because somebody quashed your spirit. So the good things inside of you, there are so many things. Your personality. There are things about you. Are you a good listener? Are you a good friend? Do you care about other people? Do you have a sense of humor? Are you somebody who helps others? Or you want to help, you respond when somebody's hurting? Helpfulness, kindness, all of those kinds of things. You could do a quick online search of personality traits. And some of them will resonate with you. If there are words that you don't understand, look the words up. It's never been easier, I'm telling you. Now that we have the internet, everything's on the internet. Find out what it means to be an extrovert. Find out what it really means to be an introvert. Find out who you are. Where are you on that continuum? Are you a detail-oriented person? That means that you're going to be good at things that are detail-oriented, like accounting and logistics. I could go on and on. I'm not a detail-oriented person, so it doesn't easily come to my mind. Or you could be the opposite. You could be like me. I have big picture, like the opposite of detail-oriented. And so it's a disadvantage if I'm involved in details in my work and my life. I'm not great at that. I need somebody to help me with those things. But when it comes to envisioning a big picture of what's possible, I got that. So everybody is somewhere on that continuum. Find out where you are. Character traits. That's another one. You could do a quick online search of character traits. And I mean, you could actually do it for hours because there are lots and lots and lots of character traits. But I'm talking about things like honesty, loyalty, integrity, perseverance, somebody who would just keep trying, tenacity, determination. There are so many really good character traits, and you have some of them in you. No, every single one of us doesn't have every single character trait. We have the ones that are inside of us, and they are exactly the ones that we need in order to find and fulfill the purpose for our life. The same is true for our personality traits. Intelligences. There are lots of different types of intelligences. So, for example, if one of the reasons that you don't like yourself or you hate yourself is that somebody told you you were stupid, somebody told you you just weren't smart enough, you can never understand that. Okay, maybe you're just not good at this or that, but there's a type of intelligence that you have that makes you amazing. Here's another online search. Look at the different types of intelligences. Find out all of these things about you. One of the most significant things about you, one of the things that truly sets you apart, is what you know for sure. What you've learned along the journey of your life. You've seen some things. You've heard some things. You've experienced some things. And from every one of those things, you have learned and incorporated them into your being. They actually become woven into the fabric of our being. These are the things that we learn as we go through the bumps and bruises of life, the great times of life, like things that you've done that you didn't think you could do, and somehow you figured it out. Somehow you got through, you made it. When we begin to give ourselves credit for the things that we've survived, the things that we've learned along the way, the types of intelligence that we have, the character traits, the personality traits, we can't help but begin to like ourselves. And hopefully we can get to the point where we actually love ourselves. And just get away from all of the other opinions that led to us feeling badly about who we are. Now, let's not overcorrect and get arrogant. I know you won't. But it's not arrogance, it's not boastful to just look at the skills and the talents and abilities and all these other things that we have inside of us that God gave us or that He arranged for us to acquire. And all of those things together equip us for what we were meant to do, for our purpose in life. And no matter what our individual life assignments are that form our purpose, every one of those things inside of us equips us and qualifies us to be able to do those things. See, our lives are made up of individual life assignments, and you can look at them like the chapters of a book. They all come together and they make up the story of our lives. So you might use some of what you know how to do and who you are, your perspective, your worldview, the way you see things, the way you see people. You might use some of that in one chapter and then you might not use it in the next chapter. That's okay. all of your life assignments build. So we learn something, we move to the next thing, we learn something there, we move to the next thing and we learn something there. And I like to say also in every single place that we need to give something. In every life assignment, we give of who we are and what we know how to do, and we share wisdom, kindness, love, patience, gentleness, hopefully forgiveness. So we're sharing something good, and then we're taking something. We learn something in every place we go. And so if we look at everything we do, even the most mundane things that we do, or if we're in a job, for example, that we don't love and it's just temporary, okay, try to figure out how you can give into it, be great at it, how you can make it really work for part of your purpose. Look around for somebody to help. And maybe you'll be able to bring something out too. Maybe it's a relationship. Maybe it's somebody that you meet. Maybe you meet the person who's going to give you the next job or the next opportunity. But it all works together. In fact, that's true even when we've made a wrong turn, let's say through our own actions, we find ourselves unemployed or in a really difficult relationship, painful relationship, whatever it is, you're there. If that is your present reality, try to make the best of it by being your best, being who you are, using all of those good things about you. And you will find that something good will come back to you too. And it's not forever. I'm telling you that when you do this, you will begin to like yourself. You will. And eventually, actually, even love yourself. And that's when life gets really good. That's when it gets really amazing. When you begin to feel like you really are enough, that you're worthy, that you can do what you're here to do. Live out your purpose. But when we stay, in those feelings of inadequacy, I hate myself, I hate my life, I hate my job, I hate my where I live, I hate my people, you know, whatever it is, when you stay in that negative frame of mind, you get more of that, guaranteed. When you do what I'm suggesting that you do, doing everything you can to be your best, to make the best out of whatever situation that you're in, while you're looking for your other opportunities, finding ways to be helpful, finding ways to be kind. It all comes together. Even the things that we've brought on ourselves through our own choices get worked together for our good. Don't ask me how. I can tell you it's happened for me a zillion times. Really, really, really amazingly. But that's a promise of God, actually. It's in the Bible. And if we'll do our best, and if we'll pray and trust Him, He'll work everything together for good. And it's too late to tell me that that's nonsense, because it's happened in my life time and time again. I want it to happen in your life too. I want you to really understand who you are and how amazing you are how awesome you are. And even if you're not, because you're leaning into all of that negativity, suspend your disbelief for a minute. Hold off on your doubt about all that for a bit. And please really think about what I've said. Do those internet searches. Look at those personality traits. You'll see yourself in there. Look at those character traits. You'll see yourself in there. Look at those types of intelligences and read the little descriptions, and you're going to hit on at least one where you go, you know what? That is me. And whoever it was, one person, a group of people, a whole entire family, whatever it is, who have led you to believe that you are not awesome, put that into perspective, that they didn't know you. They don't get to have that influence on you. Everybody gets to have their own opinion, but they don't get to influence you anymore. Not one more day. Don't give anybody the satisfaction of stealing or diminishing your worth and your potential for fulfilling your purpose in this world. Don't do it. Don't give that away. Is your potential to fulfill your purpose? That's everything. That's the reason that we're here. Don't let anybody put that light out. All right, that's it for this week. I hope you'll share this. I hope you'll subscribe and check back next week.
The things that you've been through have changed the way you see the world. They've qualified you to do what you were born to do and perfectly matched to do. Is there anything more important than finding and living the purpose for which you were born? I don't think so. I think that's the point.